Today we're going to be talking about the most common questions when it comes to QA1 shocks.
Steve, what would you say is the most common?
I would say absolutely the most common is what is the difference between the single and double adjustable shocks. It's very simple. This here is a single adjustable. It's got one knob on it. As you turn that knob, it will soften or firm both directions of this shock, and it's very easy to use. You turn the knob to the left, it softens the ride. You turn it to the right, it firms the ride. Very easy to sort out, 18 settings of adjustment, just really street-friendly shock. On the double adjustable, it is the same concept. However, you get one adjustment knob for the downward compression stroke, and the knob on the right side is the rebound, which is the extension. Now you can independently change the softness or firmness of both the up and down. That would be the most common question we get.
So great street shock, more of a track, street strip.
This one has more fine tuning available. It still works great on the street because of that. But yeah, if you want a competitive shock, doing some type of autocross or drag racing, even with your street car, the double adjustable would be the way to go. The next question that we'll hear on the tech line is they'll pull the shock out of the box and they'll say, it's not extending on its own, or it's not long enough. And the reasoning for that is that the shock has no gas charge in it. The gas charge in a shock is what makes it extend on its own. This one having no gas charge is not going to extend on its own. But the pro on the lack of a gas charge is there's no gas charge to lose over time. This is a lifetime warranty shock. It's just a very simple oil and a piston inside of this shock, so real low maintenance.
Perfect. And actually, that's a great segue. So our street shocks now have a limited lifetime warranty. Another question that I know we get on a regular basis, what do I have to do about that?
Yeah, when you get your shocks in the box, there will be a small card, a warranty card, tells you the website to go to, qa1.net/warranty. On the top of your shock, you'll find a 9-digit serial number. That is for your records, but also for you to jot down before you put the shocks into the car, so you can go ahead and register those on our website. Once you do that, I mean, they're covered forever.
Okay, so I'm got the shock ready to bolt it in. Maybe due to clearances, I can't get it in with the body down. Is it okay to mount these in different ways? Does it need to be specific? How does that work?
Yeah, absolutely. Because that shock has no gas charge in it, we're not concerned with the oil and the gas mixing together. So this shock, you can run it upside down. You can run it at any angle, sideways, whatever. It doesn't know any different. It's just gonna operate just the same.
Awesome. Same question, you know, maybe I'm measuring for shocks in a car that QA1 doesn't catalog. Mm-hmm. How do I go about that? Do I do anything different?
Yeah, we don't catalog every single car there ever was, but we do make shocks in multiple lengths, many lengths from the smallest to the longest. We've got them in different configurations where they have an eyelet, a stud top. So if you were to call the tech line and say, hey, I have a stud top shock with an eyelet lower and it's this length at ride height, which say it's 13 inches at ride height, we could tell you an exact part number of the shock that's gonna work for you.
So ordered shocks, got them in my hands, took my old ones off the car, set them down and they're not quite the same length. Is that a problem?
No, not at all. So here at QA1, we catalog our shocks based around the ride height length. That gives you the maximum amount of compression and rebound travel with that length of shock. So when you take a shock, a factory shock off of your car, our shock may not necessarily be quite as long, but that extra length in your stock shock is just unused length. So we catalog it around where the car is actually gonna sit.
Well, hope that answers all your questions. As always, feel free to call our tech line if you have anything else you wanna know. Check out qa1.net, read through our tech articles, and as always,
go drive it.